Hi dear friends, this is Elena. Today I'm introducing you to fabric outliners. You'll find out what they are used for. I'll demonstrate for you different types of outliners and how they should be applied to fabric. As always, more tips and explanations are in the lecture notes to this lesson. Let's first of all try and understand what is a fabric outliner. When I say outliner, and as I mentioned earlier, there could be several names to this tool. You can find the name as some sort of decor pen, a gutta. It could be something like contour, depending on the language. I'm working with a really international line of art materials, so let's get back to the names. Different brands name this art tool in different way, but one thing stays the same is the use and intent of this art material. Liners, outliners, let's stick to the word outliner, is intended to create outlines or thinner lines. So one quick thing to understand about what is textile liner or outliner is that it is fabric paint which has a bit of a thicker consistency, not just a thick fabric paint. It has a little bit different content which allows the painted line keep the shape. Now we have different types of fabric outliners. They could have slightly different purpose. Let's first start with the colors and effect. You may find fabric outliners in regular colors or in bright fluorescent colors. We can also see a beautiful range of glitter outliners. A glitter outliner, in short, is paint with particular shade and also mixed with the glitter powder. We can also find the outliners which help create dimension. They're called very often 3D. Some pens are used specifically to create the line which pops up once heated and stays in this way. All these art materials which have the similar purpose could look differently, meaning being packed in different tubes. Yeah, let's call them this way. But one feature would still be the same, is that all of them have nozzles. Yeah, thin nozzles like a pen. Most of materials you can find in soft plastic. Others could be found in the metal tubes, which you can gradually like this. Yeah, once you keep using it, you can then just roll it and make sure that the whole product is consumed without waste. The first steps, which we always should do whenever we are about to start using the outliner. No matter in what kind of tube our outliner is, plastic or metal, we always have to very, very properly shake them. Because just like with fabric paint, these art materials, they are prone to separate into different ingredients if they are left without any action for some time. So we shake them properly. All right, then let me start with this guy. Before starting using the pen, we need to make sure that we let out all the air which could be hiding between some portions of paint. This basically reminds me of work with the syringe. You have to first let out some air from the nozzle and then only be more or less confident that the line won't break. The first tip is how to hold the tip. We need to always watch out and not place the outliner pen vertically. It should always be sort of
under 45 degree angle. We need to calculate the degrees precisely, it just should be on the side. And we don't completely press the pen to the paper, we keep it on basically like 1 millimeter up, slightly touching. Once you try to do it, practice, your smart hand is going to understand what it is like. Let me show you this three different ways. Like, one way is gonna happen if you do the thing it the right way, okay? Alright. I let out all the air. You see here was a little bit of break of the line, and I was able to make a straight line. It happened because I'm holding the pen at the angle and I'm touching the nozzle only with the this one side, yeah, this one bottom. The camera didn't record it, but it was this line I was showing, that we also do not hover over the fabric, okay? We do not do like this, because first of all, we lose the control. Second, the paint will not get properly absorbed into fabric, because it will be excessively on top. Now, moving on, let's try and make the curly line, or even sort of an oval or a petal with the contour. We will work in the same manner as I showed you on the angle, and we always try to make the moves from ourselves. Like this. It will also, it might also work if you will do the one continuous line. But what happens, work without liner really requires a bit of a practice, because we should always keep the tool on a under the angle. But if we forget about it for a moment, and on the way back our hand goes like vertical, right? It might just feel like it. We might lose the integrity on the line, or something might just go wrong. That's why it's better not to be in a hurry, and in the beginning practice and always pay attention that you're holding the outliner in the right way, that your pressure is moderate and just the way you need it, alright? This is a very common thing that happens when we try to make a continuous line. It's neither good nor bad, it's just happening, and this is it can be fixed. We go back to the place and gently, now already over the line, not pressing it, we fix carefully the area like this. What I want to tell you that that at this moment I'm using the outliners which will eventually go flat on the fabric. Like right now you see them as dimensional ones, but in one and a half hours the entire paint will be completely absorbed into fabric. It will be flat, especially after you iron it. So do not expect that the line is going to remain like this. That's why you should be especially careful when handling the painted design created with outlines or featuring any outliner. Not to smudge it, because just like a regular paint, fabric paint, it's the same, in the same way very difficult to fix the stain or wash it off the fabric. It's not possible. A representative of dimensional paint is truly puffy. Also, there is a product from Curl. They also have special 3D liner. I don't have it at the moment, but this PicTix plaster and liner pen is also multi-purpose. You can see of papier. This is for paper, ceramics, fabrics, and other stuff. It has a soft finish. That's why we can use it on different surfaces, including on the fabric. Now, this tool is, check it out, you see there are even bubbles. So we really have to be careful before using it on fabric. We need to very, very, very properly shake it. And then squeeze out a rather proper amount of it on the paper. Now the same was puffy. This paint is rather liquid. See, so be careful and shake it and squeeze out the air. This kind of outliners, as I said in the beginning of the video, they help us create something dimensional. Okay, if we do like this, just like it's written, or we even make smiley face. Ooh. This type of paint will remain like this dimensional, though it is gonna like tulip is rather liquid. Even though dimensional, it will get absorbed and it will settle down a little bit into fabric. But once we will heat set it, this entire design will pop up, and it will be like dimensional and voluminous to touch. And the last one and very interesting art material is pearl pen. Okay, it's written. This is from PentArt. It's called 3D decor pen. Most of pens with such purpose are called pearl pen. As I mentioned, Bebel also has them. Many other brands, in fact. So that's just the one which I'm going to show you today. How we work with them in the same manner. We shake them. We remove the air, and it's very important with this kind of pen, with this kind of outliners. I like PentArt because it has a good consistency. You see, it's not as liquidy as Curl, but it's good. It's really has good texture, not too thick, but firm. With this kind of let's call them pearl pen only, you can create both lines and pearls. But mostly, it is intended to be used for creating beautiful pearls. Now let's create a line with it in the same manner as regular outliner. We keep it under the angle. All right. It is a little bit more difficult to create line with this pen, at least for me, I feel, because it's thicker. You see, I really need then to make a thick line, and it keeps wanting to you know, shut the line and make it a pearl, which I'm gonna do now. Look at this beauty. Let me make it closer. Very beautiful. So we also do it not vertically, even though vertically it also will work, but in my experience I like it better when I hold the pen. And the angle. Okay, now how to make big or small? Well, basically the more paint in a slow manner you will be squeezing out, the bigger will be your pearl. The less, the smaller. But again, do not be in a hurry. especially with the small ones, because you see the vein sort of stretches and, like, you know, keeps wanting to come back to the tube, so I don't want to smudge it, so I'm being very careful. You see how beautifully they pop. Let me show you the dimension. Look, they're really voluminous, and now the best part, they're gonna remain like this. This is the way these beans, these pearls stay on fabric. Isn't it wonderful? It's basically liquid beading. I love it. You have to be a little bit advanced with ironing such design, but it does require a very solid time for drying. Like, you have to make sure that this paint is completely dry before you even think of ironing it. As a resume, we can create beautiful beading. We can do anything, basically, what brings our imagination with the texture outliners. We can either create the entire design, something funny or something serious, with dimensional outliners. We can use a regular outliner for outlining the painted design, or also do something individually, independently. Outliners are great for painting mandalas. These are the designs created out of dots, lines, and circles. I also like very much work with outliners in a freestyle way. Like, you can literally even write something with it. Yeah, the signature. Just a moment. Ooh. Something pretty, or even something messy. Sometimes I like to use this feature of the fact that, you know, outliner changes the texture, and I want to show it to those people who are into abstract art, because it is cool to have some tool which can do something nice and neat. Yeah, especially like when you have a good control. But it's also nice to know that some materials also allow you to go a little bit crazy and get creative, let's say. It's great to explore different art materials to understand what you're drawn to. And that's what opens up our creativity. That's what helps us create some really unique things which respond to our personality. And when that's how we are able to create one-of-a-kind things, things that inspire not only us, but make others look at it and say, wow, let me also learn how to do like this. I thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. See you in the next one.